Battleground Texas, a group that is formed to turn Texas blue.
A group of Obama campaign alumni formed Battleground Texas with the thought that if they can turn Texas blue nationally, Republicans will struggle to win presidential elections.
This is Will Davies with Battleground Texas. There's an enthusiasm level which I was just unprepared for.
I'm really wondering how this is going to work out since he's in a wheelchair and most of the slogans are stand with Wendy. That's in our subconscious now, so it's interesting to me from a psychological point of view how it's going to play out.
And here you all are 11 months before the campaign election day to work on our behalf. And you are the secret weapon. You are the secret weapon.
I heard from someone that she's too stupid to be governor.
Battleground had to tell her that, you know, we're going to support you, and we had to convince her.
What I think is amazing is he's in a wheelchair, but he has no sympathy for anyone or anyone.
He may have a personality disorder.
First of all, not good looking. He doesn't speak very well. He doesn't have a good personality, and he's in a wheelchair.
We're at Battleground Texas today. Have y'all heard of us?
Yes.
I'm getting new people registered, making sure that people know exactly how to vote.
Are you registered to vote?
For Wendy?
No, just in general.
You got a Wendy Davis sticker right behind it.
I do.
I'm not registering to vote for her.
My husband is not politically active. We had received absentee forms, and I just found his name on one. I mean, is that okay?
I don't think that's legal, but I'll do like Lisa did. I didn't hear you say that.
You need to do
it all the time.
That's the latest video from Project Veritas. We have James O'Keefe of Project Veritas here to explain this video to us. All right, now, James, tell us about this video. It's seemingly going viral right now, even though it's been out for a very short period of time.
Yeah, we're approaching 200,000 views on YouTube. It's on it's all over the internet. It's about Texas. It's about the governor race in Texas between Wendy Davis and Attorney General Greg Abbott. Wendy Davis got in trouble this week regarding disabled people. Greg Abbott is disabled. He is paraplegic. He's in a wheelchair. And we have undercover cameras of Battleground Texas people. That's the political action committee trying to turn Texas into a Democratic state, which works closely with Wendy Davis. They were mocking Greg Abbott's disability, talking about how he's in a wheelchair and that's the reason why he shouldn't be governor. So this has gotten the campaign to hot water. Wendy Davis is forced to react, calling the statements abhorrent, and there's a huge controversy about the campaign's view on disabled people right now.
Exactly. Now, when did you shoot this footage, and how prevalent do you think this is as a representation of Wendy Davis supporters?
Well, Wendy Davis took credit for Battleground Texas's fundraising this week. We raised something like $12 million. Battleground Texas is a political action committee that works closely with the Democratic Party to try to flip Texas, and they're really in the business of trying to get Wendy Davis elected. So they're the driving force behind Wendy Davis, and she's taking credit for them. Now she's trying to distance herself from them, so she can't have it both ways. Mm-hmm. But we shot the footage in September and October. In the fall, we have a lot of footage, and we're releasing it now because it's in the news right now. They're talking about Greg Abbott's disability mm-hmm. and how it impacts Wendy Davis. So we released that this week, and we also have undercover people throughout the state of Texas continuing to do investigations. So we'll be releasing more as the time moves on.
Exactly. Now, I want to talk about some of the other things that have gotten Ms. Davis in hot water recently. We have this article on Infowars.com. Texas governor candidate Wendy Davis faces major backlash for Invest in Texas tweet. Now, this is a tweet she sent out, James, and she was talking about how she wants to support the Texas kids and all this. And then she got a slew of backlash by people talking about, you mean the children that you don't want to abort. Ms. Davis is a very strong supporter of abortion. So she had some very strong backlash on that front as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a rough week for candidate for governor Wendy Davis. But the great thing about this stuff is that I think it just speaks about whether she cares about people. This whole notion of war on women and everything is one narrative. What about the other narrative? What about her views on people? Mm-hmm. And I think when you disparage handicapped people, when you disparage people with disabilities, I think it spells trouble. But you know, the great thing about Project Veritas, like I said to you last time I was on your show, is that we don't really comment on the election or comment on who you should, you know, vote for. It's just about giving information about the way these people think and what they say when no one's looking. And I think it gives you a really unique insight into the minds of some of these people on the left who claim to care about people, and then they go around disparaging people because they're in a wheelchair. You can disagree with people's policies, but don't talk that way.
Exactly. I'm glad you brought up that point, because this is not a pro Greg Abbott commercial. I know the Wendy Davis supporters may try to spin it that way, but I have issues with Attorney General Greg Abbott. I'll tell you briefly, James, that here in Texas, I covered a story about a gentleman who was killed by an Austin police officer, Larry Eugene Jackson, and Greg Abbott's camp was quick to label this to be a justifiable homicide, even though Mr. Jackson was unarmed at the time of his confrontation with the police and was shot in the back of the neck. Mr. Abbott's camp was quick to label that to be a justifiable homicide. So I have issues with Greg Abbott himself. I'm not just, you know, bashing Wendy Davis. I definitely disagree with her views on abortion, but this is not pro-Abbott country, you know, pro-Abbott territory. Now, James, I want to talk to you about some other issues that are in the news and some of your other projects that you have going on. So you spent some time here in Texas. You say you also have some of your agents still here working, doing various projects, and I know you do a lot of secret stuff. But what can you tell us about?
Well, we have about 2 hours of footage that we cut down from hundreds of hours of footage of Battleground Texas meetings. A lot of election judges in the state of Texas, a lot of meetings surrounding Battleground Texas. If you saw our Obamacare videos in November and December, you saw that we touched on Battleground Texas. But there's this whole effort across the country to flip states into, they call them battleground states, like Colorado. Mm-hmm. And they bring in these groups, and they spend, you know, hundreds of millions of dollars to change the it's almost like a shadow a government or something. It's not literally a shadow, but they bring in these institutions. They don't necessarily represent the people. They represent national Washington, D.C. interests. And then suddenly the people find themselves not being represented accurately. And then you have the recall elections in Colorado. So right now that's sort of happening in the state of Texas, and it's a long ball game, as they put it. It's not just about the governor's race in 2014. It's an effort to change the political dynamic of the state of Texas. So what we're doing at Project Veritas is we have, you know, a dozen or so undercover videographers who are out there right now. I can't talk about what they're doing because I don't want to compromise the mission. But in fact, I almost didn't want to release this footage this week because I didn't want to send up red flags to Battleground. But I also feel like we have to break the news as news develops. We have to break news that's relevant to what people are talking about. That's why we broke this story this week.
Exactly. Now, James, our time is short. I want to get your comment on this because I know you're a filmmaker. You do your documentaries and so forth. Dinesh D'Souza, who made the Obama 2016 video, I don't know if you're familiar with this story, but he is in some hot water because of some political contributions he may or may not have made. Do you think that this is a potential purge against filmmakers, people who are against the establishment?
Yeah, I mean, I'm getting this. I mean, it's on Drudge right now. My group is being subpoenaed by Governor Cuomo. Governor Cuomo of New York. I'm located in Westchester, New York. Governor Cuomo made a statement last week that people who are pro-life or pro-gun do not belong in the state of New York. Now, I'm not officially a conservative group. I don't identify myself as conservative, but I'm viewed that way. And he's essentially subpoenaing me for all documents, all financial transactions. This is after I've been audited by the IRS, after I've served 3 years of federal probation for a crime I didn't commit, after a federal judge destroyed my evidence. I'm not trying to play victim here, but there are extraordinary challenges facing people like me, people like anybody who investigates and exposes fraud in the federal government. And now they're trying to subpoena me. They're trying to shut people out. And it's a story that's right now all over the internet. I'll be happy to comply with any subpoenas for any records. I'm very careful about what we do here, and everything's above board. But yes, there are. It's unbelievable that they're coming after journalists. They're coming after filmmakers. But nobody in the IRS was held accountable for their actions. You know, there's crime all over the state of New York. The pension systems were where money was stolen from the pension systems, the State University of New York. There's a lot of fraud there. And they're coming after my nonprofit organization, which does journalism. And this is the day and age we live in. And I said on Facebook yesterday, I said, okay, I'm going to leave New York. I'm going to take my office. I plan to leave New York. And then once I leave New York, then I'm going to do an investigation on Governor Cuomo. That's my plan at this point.
Well, don't stop with Cuomo. Hit Bloomberg and the rest of those guys up there. James O'Keefe, Project Veritas, thanks for your time, man.
Thank you very much.
And if you would like to follow up on some of the earlier adventures of Project Veritas, you can stop by the InfoWars shop and pick up a copy of Breakthrough. Well, that's it for this edition of the InfoWars Nightly News. I'm your host, Jakari Jackson, and we'll see you again next week.